Fake moon landing, take one.
All right, in this scene, you're on the moon and it's real and we're fooling America. And action!
I'm gonna step off the left now. It's one small step for man. One giant leap. So, I guess you want to do it again. Okay.
Do you know when NASA astronauts are lying? It's when their lips are moving. Come on, people. There's a mountain of evidence against these liars. And yet most of mankind doesn't care. The moon landings alone are such a bad joke. Just look at this ridiculous footage. Do you really think that this contraption made out of cardboard, shower rods, duct tape, and a metric ton of golden aluminum foil went to the moon and back? Just look at this piece of junk. Look at those jerky movements. This thing was hung on wires in front of some frontal projection cinema screen to create the illusion. And that's all it is. An illusion. Look at the rest of the moon footage and see impossible shadows, the same backgrounds over and over and over again, and ask yourself why there aren't any visible stars in the background. And while you are at it, look at some more NASA footage and see for yourself that they have not only lied about some things, they lied about everything. For example, a face in fake space right behind a toy model space shuttle. And why can we observe air bubbles in a lot of their space footage? Because most of their spacewalks and satellite stunts are filmed underwater in buoyancy pools. That's why. All this little impossibility here. A solid satellite capture bar morphing into a solid satellite. Do you see that? This is just a video trickery fail and has absolutely nothing to do with being in space. If these astronauts were really in space, why are they supported by wire harnesses so they can do their backflips and other circus tricks? And why do female astronauts need a ton of zero-G hairspray to make their hair look like that? It's all a giant lie. That's why. Most people working for NASA and co. don't even know it, but their main mission is to hide the fact that our Earth is motionless and flat, and that they cannot go to space because there is a dome above us all. All of this was created by God Almighty, and the Bible is not just a book, but a historical account of the divine truth. Stop being naive and do your own research with open eyes, an open heart, and an open mind, and you will come to the same conclusion.
We can help, we can join with, together we can
explore the moon and develop the moon. We should go boldly where man has not gone before. There's a monolith. They're a very unusual structure on this little potato-shaped object that goes around Mars once in 7 hours. When people find out about that, they're going to say, who put that there? Who put that there? Well, the universe put it there. If you choose, God put it there. God put it there. God put it there. God put it there. God put it there.
Right. We've been unable to track it down. I mean, we don't know where this telemetry data ended up, and we don't know what path it may have taken. So, 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 so.
If you show this publicly, you're open for a lawsuit. Okay?